Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, children.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Good afternoon.
How are you, ma'am?
Yeah, how are you, ma'am? How are you?
Fine, ma'am.
Fine, ma'am.
Okay. Let us wait for 2 to 3 seconds so that your friends will be joining. I was just trying to admit them. Please be online.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. How are you?
Fine, ma'am. How are you, ma'am?
Fine, fine. Thank you.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
How are you, ma'am?
I am fine. How are you?
Fine, ma'am.
Call your friends to join this class. If you do not find your friends here, if you have their numbers, please ask them to join.
Okay.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon very much. You can call your friends, like whomever are there in the first period. All those students I want here. So if you have any friend of yours is missing here, please call and intimate them to join the class. Okay, I think few students yet to come. Please wait, children. I will try to share the screen. Yesterday we have discussed clearly about the motion and its effects we have described, and then I have explained you about how the motion along a straight line it takes place with the different kinds of examples to make it clear for you, and I have given like 2 activities also for you as a homework, and now we have some questions actually that need to be answered. So if you have textbooks, you can open your page number 100. If you have textbooks, please open page number 100.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, for tomorrow's exam, what is the portion, ma'am?
Whatever I have told till now, you have to read. Whatever the portion, till date it was completed, that will come. But like science, mean physics, chemistry, biology, all 3 parts will come under science only. So what will happen here is biological science, you will get 60% of questions from biological science or biology. And then physics, you will get 40% of questions for tomorrow's exam. And whatever I have explained till date, you have to prepare well and read well so that you can write exam well. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. So now I request you to open, page number 100. In your textbook. Okay. 1 minute. Okay. So now you can able to see the screen, right?
Yes, ma'am.
In your textbook also, the same thing it was written there. You can see 3 questions over there. So we'll try to resolve all those 3 questions. The first question is, an object has moved through a distance. Can it have 0 displacement? If yes, support. Power gone, ma'am. No. Can it have 0 displacement? If yes, support your answer with an example. Okay. So what is this? See, he's telling an object has moved through a distance. Will that object have 0 displacement? Then if yes, support your answer with an example. So the solution will be like this. Yes, because an object moving a certain distance can have 0 total displacement. Why? Because displacement refers to the shortest distance distance between the initial and the final positions of the object. Even if an object moves through a considerable distance, if it eventually comes back to its original position or initial position. See, for example, you can take a circular motion. Okay, circular motion if you take. What will happen? For example, if you take a clock, at 12 o'clock, if the clock, you know, at 1 o'clock, if you calculate, 1 a.m. you can see in the clock, at the same time, 1 p.m. you can see in the clock. So what is happening? Initial position and the final position are same, then obviously the displacement will be zero. Yesterday, before concluding the class, the last point of our discussion is the same. When will we have zero displacement? That is what we are discussing in yesterday's class, last point. Okay, so here the displacement is zero because the initial position and the final position, okay, so are same. If it, you can easily see there, if it eventually comes back to its initial position, mean let us say you are starting from your house, okay, let us say you are starting a journey to market, so your initial position is your house, starting position is your house, you are starting from your house, you went to market to purchase something and again you came back to your house, so the initial position is your house and the final position is your house and the displacement is zero. Okay, so displacement means the when, what is displacement? When an object is placed from one place to the another place, then that is called as displacement, like how much far an object is displaced from one place to the other place. Now here you are traveling from your home, again you are getting displaced in your home to your home only. When your starting point is your home and your ending point is your home, then the displacement is zero. If at all, if your starting point is your home and if your final point is market, you are not turning back to your home, then the displacement will not be zero. It is the distance traveled from your home to the market. Whatever the distance is there, that distance is called as displacement again. Is it clear to you now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Can anyone explain how it is?
Ma'am, can I?
Please.
Ma'am, example, ma'am, I'm taking other example, ma'am.
You take any example.
Ma'am, example, our relatives are coming from Delhi, ma'am, to Warangal. They are in railway station, ma'am. Example, now they are in railway station. The train has started, ma'am.
Okay.
We have to go to railway station and come back to home, ma'am.
Okay.
So, our initial point is home.
Yes.
And we have to go to railway station, ma'am. And pick up and come to home back again, ma'am.
Yes.
And our final point is also home only.
Yes.
So displacement will be zero, ma'am.
Yes. Very good. Excellent. Yeah, excellent. That is fine. I want everybody. No, I cannot take many examples because we have to cover up with many points now. Okay. That is first question actually. And I will explain you third question and then we will go for explanation on the board. So third question also, I just want you to explain. If you see the third question, so the question is, which of the following is true for displacement? I will show you, wait 1 minute. Which of the following is true for displacement? A option he has given as it cannot be zero. And B option he has given as its magnitude is greater than the distance traveled by the object. So both are false here. Both the statements are false. Neither of the statements are true. Because statement A, what it is telling, statement A is false because it cannot be zero. It was written like it cannot be zero. So the statement A is false because the displacement of an object which travels a certain distance and comes back to its initial position is zero. Just now we have discussed. Okay, it cannot be zero means it is zero actually. Just now in the first question I have explained you. When an initial position and final position are the same, then definitely the displacement is zero. Now he is telling that in the A, the displacement cannot be zero, he is telling. No, it is false because when initial position and final position are same, then definitely the displacement is 0. So A statement is false now. Now B statement, what is telling is its magnitude is greater than the distance traveled by the object. Obviously it is wrong, because I told you magnitude is the shortest distance between the initial and final points. Magnitude definition itself, it is the distance traveled. It is the shortest distance traveled. We can measure the magnitude by, it is nothing but it is the shortest distance traveled by from the initial point to the final point is called as magnitude. Now what is the statement it is telling? Its magnitude is greater than the distance traveled by the object. How come? So it is not greater than the, it could be with the, I mean, here I have given you an explanation also. B is false because the displacement of an object, the displacement of an object can be equal to, I mean, it can be equal to, okay, but not or but never greater than the total distance traveled. Okay, is it clear now? Either the displacement will be equal to the distance traveled. Okay. It cannot be greater than the distance traveled by the object. So both the statements are, you know, false here. Vishnu Teja, please tell me. Vishnu Teja, you have raised your hand.
Ma'am, I have a doubt, ma'am.
Ah, please.
Ma'am, what is the difference between displacement and magnitude, ma'am? Both are shortcut only, ma'am.
What? Your voice is having lot of disturbance. Once, please repeat your question.
Ma'am, what is the difference,
what is the difference between displacement and magnitude, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Displacement and magnitude. Same doubt, ma'am.
Displacement and magnitude, I have given you definition of magnitude. In my first day's class, I have prepared a PPT in which first slide is magnitude. What is the definition of magnitude? What is the definition of displacement? What is the definition of magnitude? Magnitude of displacement. Three, I have told you. Magnitude is displacement means, for example, you have a pen in your hand. Okay. You have taken the pen from your bag on, and you have taken, you have kept that pen on the table, let us say. So that is called as displacement. What is displacement is the pen is taken from the bag and it is kept on the table. The pen is displaced there. There is a change in the position of the pen there. The pen's position is displaced from the bag to the table. So that is called as displacement. What is magnitude here? Magnitude is the shortest distance between initial and final point. Pen's initial point is your bag and pen's final point is bench or the table in which you are placing the pen. So the shortest distance between the initial point of the pen and the final point of the pen is called as magnitude. It is the shortest distance. Vishnu Teja. Vishnu Teja, respond. Is it clear to you now?
Yes, ma'am.
You tell me one example.
Ma'am.
All of you don't talk at a stretch because there is lot of disturbance. Vishnu Teja, your voice is not clear.
Now okay, ma'am.
Now it is okay. Now it is okay, you can tell.
I have to give an example of...
I have explained you by giving an example of pen. You said you have understood. So if you have understood, you give me some other object as an example and explain me magnitude and displacement.
Ma'am, example.
Ma'am, can I say?
No. Vishnu Teja should say now. Please, Vishnu Teja, if you have understood, you please tell me.
Ma'am, I'm thinking of example, ma'am. One second.
Many examples are there. What to take, like?
Ma'am, I have taken a water bottle, ma'am.
Okay.
From the fridge.
Okay.
I have kept on the table, ma'am.
Okay.
Displacement is kept on the table, ma'am, because it is displaced from the fridge to table.
And that process is called as displacement.
That process is called displacement. And because, magnitude means...
Because the object is displaced from the fridge to the table.
Yes,
so that displacement is called as displacement.
The magnitude means the shortest distance, ma'am.
What is the initial point of the bottle now?
Initial point of the bottle is fridge. Final point of the bottle is table.
Then how do you calculate magnitude? It is the shortest distance between. I have already told you, magnitude is nothing but it is the distance. It is the shortest distance between the fridge
and
the table. Mean initial point and the final point. Okay. Have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Anybody is having any doubt now?
No, ma'am.
Okay. We'll go to the next question.
I have a doubt now.
For this class, I mean total class will be of doubts only now, I think. Yes, tell me. Somebody said I have a doubt. So please kindly ask, but your voice is not clear. I could not understand. Your voice is not clear. Hello? Hello? Who is responding now? Who is responding? Vishnu Teja, please tell me.
Sri Tej, ma'am, not Vishnu.
Sri Tej, please tell me. Tell me. Sri Tej, please respond. No, I'm sorry. Please, I cannot hear your voice. It is like stopping, and it's coming. I am unable to listen to you, actually. Please, once again, you repeat. I'll try. Sri Tej? Okay, you know, after this class, please respond. Hello? Okay.
A to B, ma'am.
A to? Okay, your voice is not clear. I'll explain you after this class, okay? I mean, if time permits, I will try to explain you after this class. Or if you have more doubts, you can call me after this class. Okay. So the second question you just see once. Okay. So please refer your textbooks. A farmer moves along the boundary of a square field. Okay, what is there? A farmer is there. You imagine a farmer in your mind. Physics is something which is of imaginations. It is something which requires logical imagination. Okay, a farmer moving along the boundary of a square field. You know field? Very. I think everybody knows what are fields. Green fields, rice fields. Okay, we have agricultural fields. Okay, now you have to imagine a square field. Okay, now a farmer is walking along the boundary of a square field. Okay, of which side is 10 meters? He is walking or he is moving along the boundary of a square field of side 10 meters in 40 seconds. Then what he's asking us is, he's asking us what will be the magnitude of displacement of the farmer at the end of 2 minutes, 20 seconds from his initial position. Okay, he's asking what is the magnitude of displacement of the farmer at the end of 2 minutes, 20 seconds from his initial position. Okay, so now, like anyone can tell me what is meant by magnitude of displacement?
Ma'am, it is shortest way from the initial point to the final point.
Yeah.
Ma'am, the answer is 35, ma'am.
Answer is 35? How?
Yes, ma'am.
How? Who is responding? Vishnu Deja is responding?
Yes, ma'am.
How did you calculate?
Ma'am, 10 meters in 40 seconds means 80 seconds, 20 meters, no, ma'am.
What 80 seconds?
No, ma'am. They asked the time, no, ma'am.
What
10 meters in 40 seconds, they asked.
No, see. How you have calculated 80 seconds? I said it is 2 minutes, 20 seconds. Then 2 minutes 20 seconds means how many seconds?
140 seconds. 140 seconds.
Then how are you telling that it is 80 seconds? Okay. Anyways, it is good trial. Anyways, it is good trial. Okay. What will be the magnitude of displacement of the farmer at the end of 2 minutes 20 seconds from his initial position? Okay. This was the question asked. So let us try. I will try to explain you out. I am not your mathematics teacher, I am telling you, but I am your physics teacher. Still, I will try my level best to make it clear for you. Okay. The system is very slow. Okay, it's coming. So I think if I want everybody to read the question well, until unless you understand the question, you know, you cannot understand the answer. If you do not understand the question, you cannot understand the answer. Okay, what is given there is, first of all, we need to, okay. Are you able to see the screen? Solution, let us see. Okay. Oh my God. Ma'am, you are using Easy Board or Easy Note? Okay. You are not using any board. One minute, Nanna. Yeah. Okay, what is given here, we will see. Okay. Board is not writing properly, so please try to understand. The farmer is moving along the, what is given in the question is, the farmer moves along. I want everybody, whatever the points I'm discussing, even it is PPT or whatever it is, you have to note down the answers. Again, notes is not given separately to you. So whatever I'm discussing, you have to note down in your running notes, because tomorrow exam or whatever theme and exam you have, unit and exam you have, everything you have to read from this. Okay. So farmer moves along the, boundary. What is happening? I'm not understanding with this board. Yeah, it has come again. Farmer moves along the boundary of a square field. Of one side, ma'am, there is a lot of problem with this board. In the question, it was given already, like farmer moves along the boundary of a square field, okay, of side in 40 seconds. Okay, The distance traveled is 10 meters for one side of the field, agricultural field. For example, 1 minute, let me complete, later you ask me doubts. Are you able to see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
First you listen, then we will have discussion. Okay, discussions are always welcome. Okay, first let me complete it. In middle, if you ask, again, this board is giving me a lot of problem and again, I will get confused. Okay. So now what I'm telling is the farmer moves along the boundary of a square field of a side, of a side or a single side or of one side. He takes a time in 40 seconds. The distance traveled is 10 meters. Okay. So first, if you want to calculate the magnitude of displacement, you need to do 3 steps. Okay. For example, let us say here there is a person standing here. He is traveling from here and he is traveling from here and he is traveling from here. And he is taking the distance from one side, like A to B is 10. Okay. In 40 seconds, he was traveling from A to B. And again from B to C, again, I think it is 10 meters, again 40 seconds. Okay. So now, the total distance traveled by the farmer in 40 seconds, we have to calculate. Here, only one side it is telling, in 40 seconds it is 10 meters. Then, what is the total distance traveled by the farmer? I mean, total distance means this all distance. If you want to calculate, then we can calculate by 4 sides we have for a square, and then 4 sides, each side is of 10 meters again, then it will come as 40 meters. Because square is having 4 sides, we have taken 4 here, okay? And each side already in the question, it was clearly explained that it is 10 meters distance for one side. So when we calculate it for 4 sides, 4 into 10 meters, we will get like 40 meters. Till now it is clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, how to move up, ma'am? It will not move up. Again, new slide, we will get it. I know, I want this. Okay. Yeah, okay. And then, now we have calculated the total distance traveled by the farmer. That is, total distance we have already calculated now. Total distance now we have calculated as 40 meters. Now, the average distance covered by the farmer in 1 second is. So, we have to calculate like what is the average distance covered by the farmer in 1 second. How will we calculate that? Average distance covered. Mean to get the magnitude of displacement, we should get the distance traveled. Without knowing how much the distance total it was traveled, what is the average distance traveled, we cannot calculate the magnitude of displacement. So in order to calculate the magnitude of displacement, we are calculating total distance and average distance. Here you have to remember 1 second. We are calculating for 1 second and we are calculating average distance. is, it is 40 meters we have got the total distance traveled by time, like 40 seconds we have got, okay? So now if you calculate, the answer is 1 meter. So in 1 second, the average distance traveled by farmer is 1 meter. Okay. Now the time given is in the question paper is 2 minutes. How many seconds? 20 seconds it was given. So if I convert this 2 minutes into seconds, how many seconds it is? 60 plus 60?
120.
120 plus 20? It is?
140
seconds.
Okay. Then, now we want to calculate the total distance traveled by the farmer in 140 seconds. So for 40 seconds, we have known already. It was given like 10 meters. But for 140 seconds, if we want to calculate, then already we have got average distance traveled. 1 meter is equal to, 1 meter is the average distance traveled into 140. Then we will get 140 meters. Okay. Till now it is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
See, to calculate the magnitude of displacement, we have in question there is nothing given. So we have to first calculate what is the average distance covered in 1 second. So if you get average distance for 1 second, then for 140 seconds, you can calculate the average distance. So directly you cannot calculate for 140 seconds because 2 minutes 20 seconds were given. So 2 minutes 20 seconds, if I convert it as, if I convert all the minutes into seconds, it is 140 seconds. So to calculate for 140 seconds, you need to first have the average distance for 1 second. If you calculate one for 1 second, then you can calculate the distance for 140 seconds. So hence, first I have calculated average distance covered by the farmer in 1 second. Then we have got as 1 meter. Now second step, what I am doing is, now I am calculating for 140 seconds. So I have got it as 140 meters. Now what I will do is, since the farmer is moving along the boundary of the square field, so this is a square field, let us say. Okay. A, B, C, let us say. The farmer is moving from here to here, here to here. The farmer is moving from here to here, here to here. Again here to here, and again here to here. So each movement, each turn is called as lapse. Each turn, whenever he is taking a turn, each turn is called as a lapse. Okay, so to calculate the magnitude of displacement, we should also know like the number of laps completed by the farmer. So the total number of laps completed by the farmer can be calculated as follows, can be calculated like, will be, now we have 140 meters, okay? 140 meters is the total distance traveled by the farmer in 140 seconds by 40 seconds. For a single lapse, it is 40 seconds time. Okay, this 40 seconds is for single lapse. It is time, and then the total distance is 140. So now you will get the total, you know, the average lapse is
3.5
laps. Okay, so now we have calculated the average lapse also. Then the displacement of the farmer depends on the initial position, because in a square, from where the farmer is starting is called as initial position. Now, if we want to calculate the displacement, then definitely we have to understand the initial farmer position of the farmer. So if the initial position of the farmer is at one center of the field, for example, this is the field and A is one center, B is one, C is one, and D is one. Okay, so if the initial position of the farmer is at one center of the fold, the terminal position would be at the opposite center. For example, if we take farmer is starting from A point as, you know, initial point, and if we consider the final position of the farmer, or, you know, final position, obviously it will be D. It is initial position. Okay. And you consider C as the final position. This is all physics is nothing but it is all assumptions in your mind. Okay, you have to always draw an imaginary pictures. Whatever comes into your mind, you have to first apply it. Whatever the problem I am telling you, it is not that the same problem will come in the exam. It is not like that. Okay. It is an exemplary problem, I'm telling you, but you may get a model problems like this. Okay. So what you have to apply is, see, magnitude is always the shortest distance between from one point to the other point. So now in this square, this is a square agricultural field is of square shape. So now the farmer has traveled from A to B and B to C. But to find out the magnitude of displacement, I will always take the shortest distance. Okay. The shortest distance is directly from A to C. I cannot, again, A to B I have to travel, B to C I have to travel. It takes long distance. If the shortest distance between initial and final point is AC, AC is the shortest distance. If I want to calculate this, then I have to go. The total displacement of the farmer will be equal to the length of the diagonal line across the opposite corner of the square. This is the same. Whatever I'm writing, it's going. It's becoming a lot of headache again. 1 minute, children. Okay, so this is a square, let us say. Okay, so I have already told you initial point is A, and then I have already told you the final point is C, and in middle you have B. So the farmer is traveling from A to B and then B to C. Okay, but if I want to calculate the magnitude of displacement, I have to take shortest distance between initial point and final point. So this is the initial point and this is the final point. Okay, the short